Hi, welcome to Electrical Protection Channel. Plug in, play and enhance your protection skills. Today we are going to learn about how to make a polarity tester on your own. So what is the purpose of this polarity testing? By doing this polarity testing, we can find out the relative polarity between the primary and secondary windings of an instrument transformer. How to do the polarity testing? The diagram shown here explains how to do the polarity testing of a CT. Here we have P1 and P2, which are the primary terminals of a CT, and S1 and S2 are the secondary terminals. Here P1 P2 are connected to a DC source through a switch, and S1 and S2 are connected to a galvanometer. The idea here is when a small DC voltage is applied to P1 and P2 through a switch, a small current flows through P1 and P2 which will induce some EMF in the secondary, that is in between S1 and S2. Depending on the polarity of the induced EMF, the galvanometer shows the deflection. This is how we can test the polarity of a current transformer. What do we need to make this polarity tester? Let's see. Center zero galvanometer, one number. Two numbers push buttons with 2NO plus 2NC contacts each. Four numbers banana sockets. One number 9 volts DC battery. Alstom MBCH relay case, one number. On this relay case, we need to make holes appropriate to house all these banana sockets, galvanometer and the push buttons, and few connecting wires and lugs to make the connections. Whenever we do polarity testing, we need to test for both forward polarity and reverse polarity. First, let us study the circuits of these forward polarity testing and reverse polarity testing separately. This is a simple forward polarity testing circuit. Here we have used one DC source and only one push button, which has 2NO contacts, only 2NO contacts. We have not used any NC contacts here. Here NO contact means normally open contact. That means when the push button is not pressed, the contact is open. When the push button is pressed, the contact will close. Here we have used 2NO contacts. That means when the push button is pressed, both the NO contacts will close and the circuit gets closed, and P1 and P2 will get the supply. Like P1 will get the positive and P2 will get the negative, which will induce the EMF in secondary circuit, and accordingly the galvanometer shows the deflection. This is how we can test the forward polarity. The circuit shown here is for reverse polarity testing. Here also we have used one DC source and one push button with only 2NO contacts. The circuit is almost similar to the forward polarity testing circuit, but only thing is the source, DC source contacts are reversed. That means when the push button is pressed, the NO contacts will get closed, the circuit will get closed, but if we observe here, P1 will get the negative supply and P2 will get the positive supply. So which will induce the EMF in the secondary, and accordingly the galvanometer shows the deflection. This is reverse polarity testing. We want to test both the forward polarity testing and reverse polarity testing using only one kit. So combining both the circuits will look like this. Here we have one DC source, one forward push button and one reverse push button. And we have used only 2NO contacts of each push button. So totally we have 4NO contacts here. For easy understanding, I have given the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4 for the NO contacts. 1 and 2 are the NO contacts of forward push button. 3 and 4 are the NO contacts of reverse push button. Here, to do the forward polarity testing, when forward push button is pressed, the contacts 1 and 2 will get closed and P1 will get the positive and P2 will get the negative. Accordingly, the EMF will be induced in the secondary and galvanometer shows the deflection. To do the reverse polarity testing, when we press the reverse push button, the contacts 3 and 4 get closed and P1 will get the negative supply and P2 will get the positive supply. and accordingly we get the deflection of the galvanometer. So we can do reverse polarity testing also. Fine till now, but what will happen if both the push buttons are pressed simultaneously by mistake or somehow? If both the push buttons are pressed, then all the contacts, that is all the NVO contacts 1, 2, 3, 4 will get closed. Then as shown here, the circuit gets formed, but this is a dead short circuit against our DC source, which will spoil our DC source. So in this situation, we need to break the circuit somehow to save our DC source. For this purpose, we use NC contacts for each push button. When we use NC contacts, the circuit will break when we push the button. This is how the circuit will look like with the use of NC contact. As we can see here, there are two push buttons, and for each push button we have used 4 contacts, 2 NVO contacts and 2 NC contacts. And we have placed the NC contact in series with the NVO contact. Here again we have used numbering for the contacts for easy understanding. 1, 2, 3, 4 are the contacts of forward push button, 5, 6, 7, 8 are the contacts of reverse push button. When only one push button is pressed, the circuit will operate similar to our previous circuit. That means supply will get extended to P1 and P2. But when both the push buttons are pressed simultaneously, if we observe here, since the NVO contact is in series with one NC contact, when both the push buttons are pressed, the NVO contact get closed, but NC contact will open, which will break the circuit. This is how we can avoid the dead short circuit in case both the push buttons are pressed simultaneously. So after connecting the DC source and push buttons and the galvanometer like this and incorporating them in the Alstom case, our final polarity test kit will be ready. And it will be as shown in this diagram. Here if we see, we have banana sockets, 4 banana sockets, 2 for P1 and P2 and 2 for S1 and S2. And we have a center zero galvanometer, and we have forward and reverse push buttons. So this is how we can make your own polarity test kit to test your instrument transformer's polarity.
Thank you for watching.